షార్ట్ హ్యాండ్ స్పీడ్ 80 వర్డ్స్ పర్ మినిట్, 7 మినిట్స్ స్పీడ్. స్పీడ్ నెంబర్ 2 కే షార్ట్ హ్యాండ్ స్పీడ్ 80 వర్డ్స్ పర్ మినిట్, 7 మినిట్స్ స్పీడ్. నౌ రైట్ డౌన్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఏ ప్రివిలేజ్ అండ్ ప్లెజర్ ఫర్ మీ టు ఎక్స్టెండ్ టు యూ ఆల్ ఏ వెరీ వారమ్ అండ్ కార్డియల్ వెల్కమ్ టు దిస్ 6th యాన్యువల్ జనరల్ మీటింగ్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ కంపెనీ. ఐ ఆమ్ ఇండీడ్ థ్యాంక్ఫుల్ ఫర్ యువర్ ప్రెజెన్స్ విచ్ రిఫ్లెక్ట్స్ ది కీన్ ఇంట్రెస్ట్ దట్ యు హ్యావ్ బీన్ టేకింగ్ ఇన్ ది వర్కింగ్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ కంపెనీ. ది యాన్యువల్ రిపోర్ట్ టుగెదర్ విత్ ది audited statement of accounts and the director's report which have been in your hands for some time now therefore pertains to the working of 17 months period ended 31st August 1983. I presume you have had the opportunity of going through the same. With your permission, I propose to take them as read. The working results for the period under review are not comparable with that of the previous year, which have been severely affected due to loss of effective production of about 6 months on account of suspension of operations. All of you will naturally be interested to know about the present working of the company. During the first quarter of the current year, you will be happy to note the levels of production and sales have been much encouraging. In view of uncertainties involved, I would not like to make any forecast of the working results for the current year. Need I mention that the management will strive its utmost to improve the operations and achieve the best possible results for financing the capital expenditure as mentioned in the director's report. The company proposes, subject to the approval of the members and other concerned authorities, to make a rights issue of secured non-convertible debentures of rupees 6 crores. I am confident you will, as in the past, extend your fullest cooperation and support. May I, at this stage, with your permission, now deal in brief with some of the aspects of the environment in which we are to operate. I sincerely hope this will enable you to evaluate the situation in its proper perspective. The year just rolled by was gloomy on the economic front, largely due to a wide spread drought and recession. The drought, apart from causing adverse effects on agricultural production and power situation, also contributed to inflationary pressures. Let us thank the Almighty for satisfactory monsoon this year. As a result, our country is poised for a bumper crop of food grains, oil seeds and cotton. The output of oil seeds and cotton is also expected to reach a new high. The downward revision of fertilizer prices was a correct and timely decision. Thus, the overall outlook of the current year appears bright. Certain features, nevertheless, are discernible. Recession continues to haunt industry. Infrastructural deficiencies in areas of coal, both as to quality and quantity movement of freight by road and rail and power, continue to hamper the industrial growth. The balance of payments position too continues to the adverse, indicating the need for sustained efforts to promote exports, especially in view of the bleak prospects of any external aid. The timely measures adopted by the Government of India have gone a long way in curbing inflation, which is an international phenomena. Inflationary pressures, however, have been of late gathering momentum, and an all-out effort is called for before it assumes frightening proportions. Before I conclude, I would like to express my sense of gratitude to the bankers for their continued and active support.